Hello, everyone. I'm Tessellating Hexagons. This is Ripened Tingle's balloon trip of faff. In the last episode, we made it to the Dark Forest, and Buriki is giving us the runaround.
The pod crashed.
Yeah, we remember.
Cause unknown. The street to the city.
I think you mean road, but I'll let you have that one.
Cut off by the cloaked man. Reaching the city under these circumstances. Impossible.
Well, maybe with that attitude.
A different route must be found.
I was not expecting you to come around on my pep talk so quickly.
That is all.
Oh, so this is farewell? Kind of sad.
Tingle watches that face.
Hey, that's right. If I go to the city, I'll learn manners. If you go to the city, your wishes come true. My auntie said so.
Really?
She said so, right, mister?
Not that I recall, but I'll take the fish hook that you're... I'm going to hype you up. I think you're lying for our benefit, so sure.
So there. Don't you have anything that you wish for, miss?
Wish?
Yeah. Something you want to do or become? Anything like that?
There is something.
See? Then let's go together. If we go together, we'll make it there somehow.
You had me until the lack of planning part.
Hey, come on! Yay! We're companions! Good friends! Yay! You too, mister!
Yay!
Come on, mister!
Okay, but... fine. Buriki, join the party? Bequeathing to us a boot to the head. But, hey, you know... formally, Tin Man joins party, as foretold. We can now use analysis at will. Cool beans. So, what do we do with this newfound fangle? Well, first of all, can we... salamander? Okay. That gave us nothing. Fine. Well, my first thought... well, that, you know what, actually, no. I was going to say, let's go and look at that tall tree once again, but first of all... Buriki, you were analysing this bell before. Share your insight with us, if you please.
Material, mostly copper. Weight, approximately 100 weights.
I am unfamiliar with the system of measurement. But, fine. Okay, you know, if... I mean, that makes it easier to localise, I guess. Instead of having to worry about, you know, pounds and inches and squonkles and such. And you're not going to wake up ever again. They do recharge over time, but I'm recording this right after the last episode, so maybe don't worry about it. So, please analyse this tree. Look at this tree!
Length, roughly 20 lengths.
Again, I think this is to metric as metric is to imperial. Very, very function over form.
Identified. A lack of stability at the base.
Teehee?
Possible method for crossing chasm. Toppling the tree.
Yeah, okay, well, let's do what we could, let's do it to it. Or not. No bingus.
Retrying is possible.
Okay, sasshole. Try it a subsequent time.
Commencing countdown. Will execute at 0. 3, 2, 1. recalculating the strength necessary to take the tree down. Necessary power calculated. It will take approximately 100 horse.
Again, big fan of this really functional measurement system. But can I get a new spleen, please, madam?
Our power is estimated at only 50 force.
Mystery acquired. So we're going to need approximately 5 purple Pikmin. Duly noted. Hello again, owl. You're an owl. Wonderful consistency with that. Well, what can we do? No, really, I don't actually remember what the journey is from here, so maybe we can head back around and find something at the pond? You know what? No. There is a local denizen whose wisdom we could consult. Tree with a face. We heard a loud noise from afar. Well, then, human-faced tree, you can wait your turn. We heard a loud sound. Let's go and investifart. Does anyone remember investifart? That was a thing that happened. And, yes, this is a one-way thing, by the way. You can't climb back up to go around in the loop, but you can come down. So, hey, Taco Bell relocated. Huh? Thank you, Kakashi. That was very useful insight. There's a fresh bell. Maybe it's the same one, maybe it's different. Mind if I pester you, plant? Give me some money, please. Horrifying. It does give you a little bit of grace, so just don't go too ham. The reward is not worth the risk. Well, it is, just don't overdo it. Kakashi, please climb this tree. Maybe this will have something more than just money, although if it is money, I'm not going to complain.
I found something!
Is it money? Cash shmoney, we're over 500! Hell to the yum. Well, we can go this way, so let's go this way. Heading towards the dangerous tick mark of doom involving features. Oh, we got money this time. I see some jiggling things. There appear to be squibbles. Not much we can do about that, though. Can we head through here? There's grass. We can clear the grass and head to the south. What happens if we head to the north, though? Ah, it's another one of these one-way walls, and once you enter, you are committed to going the one way. Thank you, Buriki. Well, I will save you the journey and meet you back down at the crossroads. Yes, the journey takes a matter of seconds, but these things add up in over time, and we will be spending time. So, we were told to worry about this location a little bit because there's a gang of vicious squivvles. A leaflet is on the ground. Pick it up? Well, yeah, why not? A lovelier flyer. Might we takele a lookel at thistle? A flyer full of dubious information. Want to fall in love? Don't have what it takes? Every look in the mirror makes you sigh? Who can help? Sorry, old you. I can! Come see love ya! That sounds like an escort service, not gonna lie. A rusty, empty oil drum. Now that's a mood. Now what's twangling here? This looks like a garbage dump. But there isn't really any smell. Also no gnomes and no remains of a noodle chute. Can we at least have a look within? As a matter of fact, we can. Cork? Hell yeah, cork! It might be useful. Take it with you. Yes, I do. That is entirely something I would do in real life. In fact, just today I went into some charity shops and bought an edition of Trivial Pursuit, 2 neckties, and a folding cake stand, because I love weird stuff like that. What else is going on in here? Oh? A twig! A load-bearing twig! Everything, everything! There's an old book. It might be useful. Yeah, sure. Why not? A scary book. Is it The Tales of the Scary Door? A very scary book. It says so on the cover, so it must be true. Sure. What, you mean I can't examine it more closely than that? Well, fine. old magazine, old newspaper, nothing scary than newspaper. A useless pole that wasn't holding the- Yes, it was just doing it badly. Looks like a poster, but the colours have faded, so you can't really tell what it's about. And another lockable box. We still have the oil. Cool, can we open this? Nope, you can't open it because it's locked. I feel like there is something- Hi! Thanks. I feel like there's something else in here, and I don't remember what it is. That sure was a broom. Can we pingle some twangles and see what hoopties? There was a sentence in there somewhere. Well, we can twangle the diggles. We can hit the bottles, in English. We can make plangle noises. I will get you to tip over and spill your contents somehow. I'm determined, but not that determined. The poster does not give us a reaction. The plate barely reacts. Take the straw boy. What about the web? Badoing. But we can't hit the spider. The spider is off limits. Lovely. Well, we found a book. Not really much else going on over here, so I guess we'll just head on our way? There was a bell back here, and we still can't do anything about it. Push it! Push it real good! It's no use. Buriki, would you mind once again? Love that sound effect.
Status unchanged. Cause of movement unknown.
Well, would you mind kicking it since you're so fond of kicking things? Well, I mean, you did what I wanted you to, so I can't complain about that. But, yeah. So the question is now, what next? What's be do? Squirrels, why are you amongst the leafage? I feel like I've missed something in here. Like, I don't fully remember this part. Well, I barely remember anything in this game, to be quite honest. But I... Poke in bushes, get money. Sounds like a good time to me. I feel like I'm missing something in here. The old rag is blowing in the night. So we can interact with the twangler. And I can't investigate the roof. I've mentioned before how it doesn't smell of anything here. It's such a deranged sentence because who says that? Well, maybe if we go around again, we can inspire the bell to dislocate itself a subsequent time. Well, I was not expecting that to work. But fine. Hi! The bell is here now. Haunted Taco Bell. Well, I shall give it a push. No, Bingus. Buriki, I am frustration. Please kick it on my behalf. Still no Bingus. Then... another analysis?
Material and temperature haven't changed.
Okay, that's helpful. Then... what's be do? Kakashi, can you do anything? Here I go! Ow. I tried! You sure did. So what can we do, realistically? We have nothing that is particularly useful. I could try to sling a shot at it, but makes a different kind of ding from when Buriki kicks it, but... Excuse me? I saw something jiggling. Can you be helped? Well, that was normal. So the bell's haunted.
Hey, you. Aren't you scared? You guys. Look. See how strong I am? Ha! give me all your whoopies. And no sudden moves. No sudden moves. Oh, I'll crush you with this belt. Can you be reasoned with? Don't try to bargain. Hand over your whoopies.
Okay, well, that wasn't the answer. Buriki, you seem to be the level-headed one. Do something, please.
The three laws of robotics. 1. Do not harm humans. 2. Obey the commands of humans. 3. Other than that, do what's most convenient.
I don't think that's entirely accurate. Plus, he's not human, so, Well, anyway, we've got a scary book, and you're a coward, so, here's a scary book. And it turns out they were ghosts all along! Boogity boogity boo!
Quit joking! That didn't scare me! You can wait all you want. I'll be fine.
Well, if that's an invitation... And then a skeleton popped out! Boogity boogity boo!
Completely fine! Since I'm fine, you see, there's no need to wait anymore at all.
But I think I will. And then she spanked him on the bottom with a woman's weekly like an African drum.
Ah! I'm not scared!
Batman's strength could suffice to topple the yellow tree.
How convenient that the tree happens to also be yellow, by the way, as a substitute for the yellow bricked road.
Pursue immediately.
Well, I mean... Hunt for a coward. Please do not spoonerize that. It was foretold that we should look for a big to go with our tall and our small. Hey, Taco Bell's here. The bell has been cast away. Wilson! Well, we can go this way now. And there is a house and another plant. I shall stop when I am welcomed to stop. Well, there's another tree with a hole in it. Is this going to be of any help to us? Hi! There's a snack! Even better. I do like a good snack. Anything else in there? Kakashi, would you mind terribly confirming or denying the presence of something amongst this hole? Here I go! You seemed less enthused that time.
There's nothing there!
Hooray. One other thing I happen to notice is... Here's another hungry monk. And we have a berry. Please eat this red knobbly fruit. Hi. It's something. It looks like a Minecraft amethyst. Small flowers are blooming here. Lovely. Bats! Ah! Well, can we enter the house? No, we cannot. No bingus. The door is locked. Can we look in? Can we go in through the window? This window has crude glass in it. Buriki, punch a hole in it. That's not an option. There is a window. The curtains are closed, so you can't look inside. Well, here's a hole. And you know what we do with holes around these parts? We take the straw boy.
Yay! I get to help Mr. Tingle! Here I go!
Kakashi vanished into the hole. He's in the window! It's Kakashi! He's looking at us from inside! Shoot, dude, he sure is. Please openst the dorm. With two O's. Lovely.
Ta-ya!
Well, I'm going to infer that means the door is unlocked. Which seems like a good note to cliffhang on, so I have been and will continue to be Tessellating Hexagons, and in the next episode, we're going to head into the house. Well, log cabin. See you then for that.